Hello friends, in this video we are going to perform some test of significance for attributes. It means we will take some statistical data or statistical problems and we will perform the hypothesis test on those statistical data. So coming to this topic, if we are talking about variable, then quantitative estimation of the phenomena takes place. But if we are talking about attribute, then there may be only two possibility, either presence or absence of that particular attribute. So under test of significance for attributes, only two possibility will be there. Either it will be presence, means it will be success, or it will be not success. So accordingly, it is divided into three category. First one is number of successes. Second one is proportion of successes. And the third one is test for difference between the proportions. So in this video, we will discuss about the test for number of successes. So formula for number of successes is equal to Z is equal to X minus NP divided by under root N P Q. Here Z is equal to calculated critical value, X is equal to observed success, this N and this N is equal to size of samples, this P and this P is equal to probability of success, and this Q is equal to 1 minus P, or we may say probability of failure. So by using this formula, we will calculate the critical value, that is Z, for questions related to this topic. So our question is, a coin was tossed 484 times and the head turned up 265 times. Test the hypothesis that the coin is unbiased. So before solving this question, I will suggest you to watch my video on basics and the fundamentals of hypothesis testing. Link is given in the description. Now coming to the solution of this question. So let's consider the coin is unbiased. It means null hypothesis is number of heads is equal to number of tails. It means if our coin will be unbiased, then number of heads turned will be equal to number of tails. And the alternative hypothesis will be number of heads will not equal to number of tails. Now we have to determine whether this is correct or this is correct by using this data. So given data is N is equal to 484, X is equal to 265. Now coming to the probability of success, which is denoted by P. So any coin is having two sides, one is head and one is tail. So probability of head will be 1/2. So P is equal to 1/2. So Q is equal to 1 minus 1/2. So ultimately Q will also be 1/2. Now we are having all this value N, X, P and Q. And this formula we need X, N, P and Q. And we are having all this value. Now we have to put all this value in this formula like this. So after solving this, we will get 265 minus 484 divided by 2. So it will be 242 divided by under root into 2 into 2, so it will be 1 by 4. So z is equal to 265 minus 242. It means 23 divided by 484 divided by 4, so it will be 121. So ultimately it will be 23 divided by under root 121 is equal to 11. So ultimately calculated z value will be 23 divided by 11, so it will be approximately 2.09. So in this question no significant level is given. In that condition we have to take 5% level up significant in every case. This is a two-tailed test and the tabulated critical z value for 5% level up significance is 1.96. So if this is a two-tailed test, then this value should be considered as minus 1.96 to plus 1.96. It means error may be in the both side, in the left side also, in the right side also, as I have already discussed in my previous video. Link is already in the description. So here this is the tabulated value and this is calculated value. Now we have to see whether our calculated value is coming between both this value. So after seeing or comparing this value, our this 2.09 is not coming between this minus 1.96 to plus 1.96. It means our null hypothesis is failed. Means we have to reject our null hypothesis, and in that condition we have to accept our alternative hypothesis, and the final decision will be the given coin is biased because null hypothesis is rejected. So this is the complete solution of this question. Now we will take second question. So the question is, in 256 throws a six-faced dice, what points appeared 122 times? Would you say that the dice is fair at 5% level of significance? Now coming to the solution of this question. So let's consider the dice is fair enough at 5% level of significance. So if the dice is fair, then null hypothesis will be number of odd points is equal to number of even points, and alternative hypothesis will be number of odd points is not equal to number of even points of the dice. Now coming to the data which is given in the question. N is equal to 256, x is equal to 122, probability of success which is denoted by p is equal to 1/2. Why it will be 1/2? Because dice contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and out of these 6, 3 are odd numbers and 3 are even numbers. So half are odd numbers and half are even numbers. That is why we are taking p is equal to 1/2. Then q is equal to 1 minus 1/2 is equal to 1/2. Now we will put all this value in this formula. So it will be like this. When we will simplify this one, then it will be 122 minus 256 divided by 2, so it will be 128 divided by under root 256 into 2 into 2, so it will be 1 by 4. Now it will be 122 minus 128, so it will be minus 6 divided by under root 256 divided by 4, so it will be 64 is equal to minus 6, and under root 64 is equal to 8, so z calculated is equal to minus 6 upon 8, so it will be minus 0.75. and here we have to take 5% level of significance, so critical z value for 5% level of significance will be 1.96. It means minus 1.96 to plus 1.96. Now we have to see whether this value is coming between minus 1.96 to plus 1.96. So this value is coming between this value. It means our null hypothesis is passed. Means we have to accept our null hypothesis and we have to reject our alternative hypothesis. And our decision will be the given dais is unbiased, or we can say that the given dais is fair. So this is the complete solution of this question. Now we will solve third question. So question is that in a hospital 960 female and 1040 male babies were born in a year. Do these figures confirm the hypothesis that males and females are born in equal number at 5% level of significance? Now coming to the solution of this question. So let's consider males and female babies born are equal in number. So null hypothesis will be male babies is equal to female babies, and the alternative hypothesis will be male babies is not equal to female babies. Now coming to the data given in this question. So first coming to n, so here n is equal to 960 plus 1040, so total will be 2000. And in this question, number of female and number of male both are given, and any of these can be taken as a x. For example, we are taking 1040 as a x, or we can take 960 as a x. In both condition difference will be same. For example, half value of this 2000 will be 1000, so 1000 minus 1040 will be minus 40, and 1000 minus 960 will be plus 40, so difference will be 40 in both the conditions. Now coming to the value of p, so here p is equal to 1 by 2, so q will also be 1 by 2. Now we will put all this value in this equation, so it will be like this. Thousand forty minus two thousand into one by two divided by under root two thousand into one by two into one by two, so it will be 1040 minus 2000 divided by 2, so it will be 1000 divided by under root 2000 into 1 by 2 into 1 by 2, so it will be 1 by 4 So z is equal to 1040 minus 1000 is equal to 40 minus under root 2000 divided by 4. So it will be 500 is equal to 40 divided by under root 500, and the value for under root 500 is equal to approximate 22.36. So calculated z value will be 40 divided by 22.36, so it will be approximate 1.79. And according to this question, we have to take 5% level of significance. So 5% level of significance critical value or z value is 1.96. It means our value should be between minus 1.96 to plus 1.96. Now we have to see whether this value is coming between these. So this value is coming between these. It means our null hypothesis is passed, and our null hypothesis will be accepted. And according to this question, number of males and number of females are equal in number. So this is the complete solution of this question. Now in next video, we will solve some statistical questions related to test for proportion of successes. Thank you.